Hey, how's it going? Welcome back to my channel. This week on technology news that you need to know in India, we're talking about the Samsung Galaxy M40, the Xiaomi Redmi K20, or whatever confusing name Xiaomi decides to give it, and more. Let's get started. The official news today begin with deals. If you are in the market for a smartphone, Flipkart has the Mobile Fest going on until, unfortunately, it ends today. This is barely a week after the big shopping day's sale, so all sales are meaningless, right? Anyway, so the deal I would recommend would be the Pixel 3 regular version, 128GB storage, retailing for 59,000, or the Pixel 3 XL, 64GB storage, retailing for 55,000. The deal I would not recommend would be the iPhone 10 at 66,500. At that price, I would rather you buy the iPhone 10R. And the deal that I would completely recommend that you stay away from would be the Huawei and the Honor deals. Seriously, can we all stop recommending, buying, or putting on sale the Huawei Honor phones until we know what's going on with Google, Android, and them? Keeping in line with deals which are not really deals, but if you are considering a smart speaker with a camera, Amazon is launching the Amazon Echo Show 5, which is basically the Amazon Echo Show with a 5-inch screen in India for 9,000 rupees. Link in the description. If you are not that interested in having a speaker with a camera in your living room and someone from Amazon watching you while you eat, then you can get the Google Home Hub or the Nest Home Hub or whatever that thing is called, which is the same speaker without a camera. Unfortunately, it's not available in India. You're going to have to import it. Moving on to some actual news now, the Samsung Galaxy M40 is going to be launching in India on June 11th. As of now, we have teasers for the phone and some rumors, which is to say we know basically everything. The Samsung Galaxy M40 will have a 6.4-inch Super AMOLED display with a hole punch. Apparently, that's a big thing now. It will have triple cameras, of course, on the back, with one fake 48-megapixel camera and a Snapdragon, not Exynos, 675 processor powering it with 8GB and 128GB of RAM and storage. The phone will cost 20,000 rupees. It is a good deal. I want to place on screen now a statement given by the Samsung Senior SVP of Mobile for India, Azim Warzi, as acclaimed by the NDTV website. You can see that the Samsung Galaxy M series and the Samsung Galaxy A series are exactly the same. They do overlap in quite a number of ways. In fact, I was thinking that Samsung has given its customers an MA in confusion. Clearly, a lot is lost in the transfer of intellect from South Korea to India. Whatever the case may be, Samsung has sold 2 million units of the Samsung Galaxy M series from its launch in January and 2 million units of the Samsung Galaxy A series from its launch barely a month back. To put that number in perspective, that's double the number of OnePlus 6 and the OnePlus 6T phones that OnePlus sold last year. Taking a quick detour from smartphone news for a bit, most of us are well aware that car infotainment systems really suck. The touch response doesn't respond. The mobile operating system that is in place is terrible, so Samsung is stepping in to fix the game. The new Audi A4 launching later this year will be powered by the Samsung Exynos Auto 8890 processor with 8 CPU cores and 12 GPU cores to ensure that infotainment systems take you to the next level of car parking. Moving on to some OnePlus news, the OnePlus 7 Pro launched about 2 weeks back and everyone has given positive feedback. Most people love the Super AMOLED giant 90Hz ultra-fast display, but there are a couple of complaints. One, the camera isn't all that good. No matter how much OnePlus may tout its DxO Mark score, bottom line, in real world, the camera does not perform all that well. Second, the battery life because of that 90Hz display is a bit dismal. And finally, there is that moving part selfie camera. I for one would actually recommend the Samsung Galaxy S10e over the OnePlus 7 Pro. But if you are one of those users who never settles, then I suggest you wait for the OnePlus 7, which is going to be launching on June 4th. It has the same Snapdragon 855 processor, so it's going to be super fast. It has 8GB, 128GB of RAM and storage. It has only two cameras on the back. unfortunately. It has no in-display fingerprint sensor, no dual speakers, and obviously no 90Hz display. But apart from all of this, it is a compelling device. And talking about other compelling devices and flagship killers, Xiaomi launched the K20 and the K20 Pro a few days back in China. The phones will be launching in India as the Poco Phone F2 and the Poco Phone F2 Pro or the Xiaomi Mi 9T. Bear with me here, I think what Xiaomi is doing is every time they have a mildly successful sub-brand, they slap every one of their other brand names onto it into a combined Frankenstein entity. Anyway, the Poco phone last year was a good phone because of the specifications. It had a Snapdragon 845 at a price of sub 20,000 rupees. With all Xiaomi phones though, the specs are better on paper than in real life. So I highly recommend you look at this phone in real life before you actually decide to buy it. And finally, let's talk about YouTube Music and YouTube Premium. Google Play Music launched all the way back in 2011. I have no idea why Google decided to call it Google Play Music and not just Google Music, but Google is crazy like that. After some time in 2017, Google Play Music launched in India for the rather reasonable price of 99 rupees. At this time though, Google was already starting to merge Google Play Music into YouTube Music. Maybe Google felt that YouTube was their number one successful content brand and they needed to slap it on everything. So YouTube Music is Google Play Music with a dark theme and it gives you access to all of those rare covers and live performances on YouTube. YouTube Music and YouTube Premium launched in India a few months back for 99 rupees and 130 rupees respectively, but a day back, YouTube rolled out a student membership where if you have a valid student ID card of a college or vocational institution and you upload it and it gets approved, then you get access to both for 59 rupees or 79 rupees respectively. Although, before you go jumping on the bandwagon, I should remind you that most students don't care too much for suffering advertisement and I don't see them paying for YouTube Premium if all it gives them is ad-free access to YouTube. Keeping in line with YouTube Music, I should mention now that T-Series has crossed 100 million subscribers. Congratulations. That's about it for this week's episode, guys. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. I want to know what you guys think of this whole OnePlus versus Samsung debate. I know a lot of you have very strong opinions about it. Please let me know in the comment section down below. Subscribe to Vlog of Note on YouTube. Turn on notifications so that you never miss a video. And I will see you guys in the next one.